Here we have the cell at interphase. It's doing its normal job and hasn't started to divide. As you can see, there is still a definitive nucleus. Let's see what happens when the cell enters prophase. Here are the chromosomes during interphase. As they enter prophase, they divide and duplicate their chromosomes. The chromosomes during metaphase have no definitive position in the cell until they align along the metaphase plane. Here the cell is in anaphase. The chromosomes will be pulled apart by the spindle fibers, as demonstrated by these guys. Next is telophase and cytokinesis. This is where the cleavage furrow here forms to pinch apart the new forming daughter cells until they start to develop daughter nuclei. The new nuclei are shown by the orange Play-Doh. The blue Play-Doh are the centrioles. Now for meiosis, the process would have been the same, except the chromosomes of a sperm and an egg cell would be involved to produce a healthy 23 chromosomes. However, sometimes during meiosis too, the chromosomes don't divide correctly. Instead of Michael being pulled, he was pushed to the other side. This results in males having an extra Y chromosome, which is called Jacob's syndrome. Some of the symptoms of Jacob's syndrome are delayed maturity and over-hyperactiveness.
Ken, let's go play today. No, are you busy tomorrow? Oh, no, let's go, Ken, come on. Let's go. Ken, I'm such a poop head.
Another few symptoms of Jacob's syndrome are chest pains and joint pains, which can lead to arthritis.
Kenneth, my heart's been hurting me so much. Kenneth, oh, I can't walk today. Are you gonna give me a piggyback ride?
To relieve joint pains, one can use braces, crutches, and splints to immobilize their joints. However, under severe disease of Jacob's syndrome, the patients would have to go under surgery such as amputation or severe neuropathy and diabetes. And that concludes mitosis and Jacob's syndrome.